Hello, creative parent. Ever try to get creative and over something calls you away? Don't worry, friend. Today we're going to talk about how to get creative every day, even with all those little interruptions.
Set goals. You know, SMART goals.
SMART goals are specific, measurable, achievable, realistic, and timely. Making a SMART goal can help you focus on what you really want to achieve.
And they can help you break up larger goals into smaller goals. Slow progress is progress. Goals are something to strive for. That's why we set them. But be nice to yourself. You're working hard every day, regardless of whether you finish a piece of art. Honestly, if I'm able to work for 30 minutes straight any given day, that's a huge accomplishment. Your progress might be really slow on big pieces. If you're still learning like I am, that may feel like you're never going to get where you want to be. That's why the goals are important, right? Try to use a medium that you can pick up and put down again a lot.
Acrylic may be your favorite, but forgiving, it is not. A wet palette or Golden's line of slow-drying acrylics open can help if you love acrylics. Traditional oil paints are iffy with little ones, but you can try water mixable oil paint if you love painting with oils.
But watercolor?
Oh yes, friend. Both gouache and watercolor are easily re-wettable, and your painting will need to dry between layers anyway. Oil pastels? Why, yes, fun to be had for all ages there. Colored pencils? Don't mind if I do. And alcohol or paint markers are just really fun to work with.
Anything you can re-wet or come back to is a friendly medium for those of us who stop and start like 20 times a day. Make your studio kid or baby friendly. Invest in some bookshelves and put anything you don't want to be touched out of reach. And then stock the bottom shelves with lots of toys and books and art supplies so that your little one can have fun while you paint or draw or craft or whatever it is that you do. Include your little ones in the process. Ultra washable crayons, honey.
Also, a drawing mat with water markers, and you can use modeling clay if you have a kid that doesn't eat everything they touch. Mine does, so we skip the clay.
Get the kids being creative, and you can work while they work. They're going to be interested in what you're doing anyway, so why not let them join the fun?
Hi, if you're enjoying this video so far, please like and hit subscribe.
This is a tough one. Accept that you can't do it all. You literally can't do it all. We're not meant to raise children by ourselves. You have a messy house?
Me too.
If the dishes in the bathroom are clean, we're doing great. If you can't deal with the mess, ask for help. Or if you have the means, hire somebody. The mess level of your house is not a value statement about you as a person.
The fact is that we all do the best we can, and that looks different for everyone.
And if cleaning the house all the time is getting in the way of your creativity, that has to stop.
You see somebody who keeps a squeaky clean house, good for them. If you have a messy house, but you did something creative today, then good for you. Prioritize your goals. If you're trying to start a creative practice or a business or anything really, you have to make it part of your daily routine. And that's going to mean you may be dropping some balls in the homemaking department. Or the kids don't get to go to the park every day. Sacrificing some of the activities you do with your kids is the easiest way to make a little room in your daily schedule for creative endeavors. And if they're a little like mine, they won't miss it. Which leads me to mother's guilt. Expect it and dismiss it. You know what? Kids have to learn to play independently.
Ava loves the time we spend in the studio, and it's healthier for her if I'm not paying attention to her every second of the day. Also, it isn't your job to entertain them.
If you're a creative, you have to be able to create. Simple as that. So set an amazing example for your kids and do what you love. They get a really good look at what it's like to be passionate about something, to do it for yourself, and to work at it every day. That's the kind of stuff that we want to show our children in the first place. And our cats, too. Yeah. Know when it's time to rest and do it. The drive to create is so powerful, and sometimes it takes over and you forget to eat. Or sometimes you'll be up in the middle of the night, an inch from a canvas, painting details, and then the baby's screaming, and you realize it's too late and you forgot to brush your teeth, but you have to go up there and take care of the baby, and it's just too bad because now you're not going to get to brush your teeth because the baby won't let you leave. Just me? Beware of burnout. It happens to creatives who love what they do, just like it happens to everybody else. Doing nothing is good for your creativity too. Try being bored.
Stare out the window or at the ceiling.
Everybody stares at their ceiling sometimes, right? A spider up there. Shut down negative self-talk. Yes, I talked about mom guilt, and yes, they are different, although they do overlap sometimes. You aren't selfish because you want to do something other than mom, watch this, or feed and clean up after, and do all of the things that you do every single day in and day out, making your day seem like an endless spiral of the same day, like Groundhog Day, but the children keep getting older, and so do you. Nor are you less of an artist because you do those things. Hi, imposter syndrome. Just do the opposite of what that self-critical voice in your head says. You should submit that piece to that zine. You should keep working on pieces to submit to a gallery. Make that content. I know how easy it is to get inside your head when you work from home and you see few people on a daily basis. Don't let self-doubt sabotage you. You're doing great. So try to be creative today. I hope this video helped you be creative today. And I hope you'll subscribe and support my channel by clicking the link in the description. And have a great day. You're awesome.
Hey, if you enjoyed this video, please share and watch these other videos. Love you, bye!